This is Dr. White. How can I help you?
Of course. I'll leave immediately.
Don't worry about giving me directions. I have a map. I had scheduled my first visit with a new patient, Mr. Gray, for tomorrow, but he's had a heart attack and needs immediate attention. Can you tell me how to get to White Wolf Hotel? I'm on my way to visit a patient, but the rain is making it hard to see. Oh my God, the bridge is collapsing! It's a miracle. I'm alive. I nearly fell into the abyss.
The guest registry shows Mr. Gray is staying in room 205. Hello? Mr. Gray? I'm your doctor, Philip White. Someone called me and said you need me. There's no one here. It's a map of the hotel. I'll mark everything I need to do on it.
Begun. Can you find me?
I think I heard someone in the other wing scream. I should check it out. What happened?
Stay back.
Perhaps I can help. I'm a doctor.
You're a doctor? Thank God. He has a weak pulse. I'm Sheriff Jack Scargan. I live in room 204. I'll leave him in your care.
I need to examine him, but I left my doctor's bag in room 205.
Please be quiet. Oh, I'm sorry. What happened?
A snake bit him. Be careful. It could be anywhere.
How horrible!
Miss, I need your help. Hey, what are you doing? Stop that!
You tried to destroy evidence.
Evidence? What are you talking about? My name is Catherine Miller. I'm a journalist.
What's going on?
I made a mistake. I'm sorry for any trouble I've caused.
Perhaps you can give me a detailed account.
She tried to burn an article she wrote about snakes.
So? That's no big deal. She didn't break any laws.
No big deal? What about the man in the hallway dying from a snake bite?
You have a point. Maybe she's involved somehow. Bring me my handcuffs from my room.
You have no reason to arrest me.
Here's the key to my room.
I detect a hint of almond in the air. I have a bad... What a sinister shadow! Thank you.
I won't forget about this, Jack. I remember everything.
Jack? What is she talking about?
Shut up.
Jack, have you lost your mind? Or are you hiding something and trying to convince her to be quiet?
Great. Those should hold her.
Destroying hotel property is going too far. This situation is getting out of hand, so I think it's time we call the police.
All we need to do now is call the police. I'll check out the hotel. You try to find a telephone.
Someone's already been here. I should find another phone and call them. He'll be fine. The antidote will take effect immediately. What the hell? What a sinister shadow. Someone's already been here.
And now for the weather. Heavy rain has severely damaged local roads, prompting officials to close all roads until conditions improve. And now we have breaking news to report. A prisoner has escaped Cien Nam prison. Officials say he's armed and dangerous. Citizens should be on the lookout for a man of average height.
I knew there was something wrong. We're doomed.
Catherine, calm down. It's possible the radio station doesn't know all the details.
You hear what the man on the radio said? The rain has washed the roads away, and we're stuck inside this hotel with a criminal on the loose.
The bridge to the hotel is out, so there's no way he can get to us. Everything will be fine. Although I've handcuffed you to your chair, I'd be happy to make you a cup of tea if that would calm your nerves.
I'd prefer my freedom, but I'll take a cup of tea.
Good. I'll go get the cup I saw in room 205.
Philip White. Thanks for the tea, Philip. You seem to be a good man, so I'm going to warn you about something.
What would that be?
Be careful around Jack. Something about him doesn't seem right.
I don't like him either. He's strange.
Please, take this star. Jack dropped it.
Why did Jack keep this article about a fire in 1988? It's a stack of bonds in Mr. Zeeler's name. Most people keep these in a regular safe. Hello? My name is Philip White. I'm calling from the White Wolf Hotel. I have something urgent to report.
What happened?
One of the guests has died, and there's no staff in the hotel. Something strange is going on.
Don't panic, and stay where you are. It will take us a while to reach you, as the weather is being difficult.
The bridge to the hotel has collapsed, so you'll have to come by air transport.
Thanks for letting us know. When the weather clears, we'll send an officer your way.
Are you kidding? There might be a killer among us. How long will we have to wait?
Sir, please, be patient. We'll be there as soon as possible.
Okay, I've called the police. Now I need to let Catherine know what they said. Catherine is dead! What the hell is going on? This is a message to Jack? So they knew each other. Oh my God, who's hanging there?
Hello, my friends. This is nasty weather we're having.
We haven't met. Did you just arrive? Do you know where Mr. Gray is?
I arrived a few hours ago. Mr. Gray sent me an invitation to the grand opening of this hotel. That's why I'm here. My name is Nick Stone.
Jack Scargan, I'm the sheriff in these parts, and I'd like to ask you a couple of questions. Let's start with where you've been for the last half hour.
Why do I have to tell you? Where I've been is my business, not yours.
Listen up. Two people have died in this hotel in the last 30 minutes. Talk like that is an express ticket to prison.
Jack, why are you threatening him? It's bad protocol to intimidate people and make them feel guilty. I'm sure Nick will tell us where he was.
People have died in this hotel? Are you serious?
Two guests have died. Someone appears to have poisoned Catherine Miller with cyanide. And Kevin Taylor died from a snake bite. Things are getting complicated.
Wow. Certainly smells like trouble. I arrived a few hours ago, and when I got to my room, I found a note that said someone was waiting near the pavilion to talk with me. I went to the pavilion and waited for an hour, but no one showed up. As I was walking back to the hotel, I heard the blast.
Something blew up on the third floor, but we can't get there to see what happened because the elevator is broken, and the stairs only go up to the second floor.
The elevator was always breaking. Old Tom would curse up a storm every time he had to fix it.
You've been here before?
Yep. About 20 years ago, this place used to be a children's resort. I lived here right before the fire, which happened in the late 80s. That was a good time in my life. I used to use the workshop out back. You might be able to find some tools there. The door to the backyard is locked, but I found part of the lock on the porch. Here, you can have it.
You stayed here before the fire? Interesting. Philip, I'll stay here and keep an eye on Nick while you fix the elevator.